mindset for travel. So we're off by a day because Skip's big ass truck that's like super custom, everything, tire blew out. Well, not blew out, but separated, and all this shit happened. And it was incredible to watch how I use things that I teach here, just understanding energy, healing our shit. It totally paid off. And I'll tell you why. So let's just go back to when the tire was blowing out. We're in the middle of nowhere, right outside of Ocala, Florida, probably like 30 minutes south. Nothing's around. Right now we're in Mobile, Alabama, and we're at this old inn that's super haunted in the best way. So I have to tell you about that. And the kids don't like it because it's not brand new, but I just wanted to do it for the history part of things. But anyway, so when the tire did its thing, we're there at a truck stop. It's not a good truck stop. Like, this is the girl that actually gave us a ride said that there was like shootouts, so it was a bad part of town. We got a tow truck come in to get Skip's truck. A Friday evening, everybody's closed, especially in a small town. There was no way that we could get this tire because it's a very special tire. If you have a husband that has like jacked up cars or specialty cars or whatever, I mean, this is gonna have to be ordered. And not only that, it's going to have to be taken to a shop that the specialty tires that has a mount that can do all this stuff. Skip's freaking out. He can't even think of like what to do. Like, I mean, seriously. So I went to the store, got the kids something. Cause you know me, like my mindset, what I teach y'all, thank God, is I'm just committed to the outcome. I know that that's happening. I'm like, all right, I know that operating out of fear is not a vibe, because if I operate out of fear, it's only going to get worse. I did tons of breath work through this trip because, you know, it's hard to exercise, which we've only been on the road for 2 days, which is fine. I did some yoga up there just now. And then tomorrow I'll be back. We're a gym and there'll be gyms around. So we called the tow truck and they came, but Lyft and Uber, like, there was nowhere to be found. It was going to cost $240 to get a Lyft 30 minutes for a 30 minute ride. That's how like nobody was around. It was starting to rain. It was getting like kind of late. And I'm like, this, you know, fuck this. At this point, I'm thinking of, there's a trucker, I will get, somebody will take us somewhere. I was just unavailable to be stranded. I was unavailable for shit to go down, you know, because at the end of the day, like, I knew we were safe. It's just, we need to be at a hotel somewhere and not in bumfuck Egypt. So I went inside, and the girl behind the counter, using the people skills that I teach y'all, you know, everything that we know about people and ourselves, I use those. Not out of manipulation, it's just who I am, right? And I asked her, you know, here's what's going on. Can you do this? Can you help me with the taxi? She starts looking through business cards, and she goes, hold on, my friend, she's coming up, and I think she's got you. And I'm like, oh my God, because I said, I'll pay her $100. And she goes, well, she smokes. And I was like, that's fine, I got weed right here. And I actually had a bunch of extra pre-rolls, and they were like, oh my God, yeah, and I just gave them one. Gas station, never met this girl. She was like, you thought I would have given her $500. So that felt good because she was helping me so much, right? Just out of the goodness of her heart, she saw my family and my little kids and was like, yeah, I'm going to call my friend. Her friend gets there. It's hilarious. 20 years old. Kind of, you'd say, a hot mess express. I love her. It's almost like I grew up with people like her. And I was like my brother. She acts just like my brother. And she had like a Volkswagen car. It was a nice one, but she had wrecked the front of it. Hit a deer. 90 miles an hour. Funny as shit. And all this is going to be on a vlog. And you'll see her. She was on my Instagram. So I paid her $100. And getting from there to the fucking hotel, dude, it was like, at that point, I'm so in flow state. You could call it survival mode, but it was a different, I wasn't operating out of fear. It was a calm, all is going well energy. And I was just unavailable for anything else. And getting to the hotel, same thing, using, you know, the people skills and whatnot, the guy on the hotel other line, his attitude at first was just kind of a certain way, but I continued to be in my own energy while I get to the hotel and he hooked me up. He goes, you were actually already like a Hilton's reward member and all this stuff and had a gift bag there. So the kids had snacks and waters. And I was like, dude, this is so awesome. And they were just like happy people. They knew our story because I had been talking back and forth with them, you know, just genuinely like sharing how I felt, not blaming anybody, because that's what a lot of people do. You know, they go in Karen mode and it's like getting pissed at their husband, you know, and Skip said that. And he goes, do you know how many women would have been fucking pissed, shitting their pants and pissed off at me, like fighting. I'm like, wow, how, why? Because most people in their wounded state, you know, blame. Everybody wants to blame somebody. That does no good. So we never got in a fight. We haven't fought. That's the cool thing. And I heard somebody else, an old man, that was like, God, you're going to go on a trip like that or whatever, and y'all are going to be fighting. He actually said that. And, you know, a lot of wounded men and a lot of wounded women, they would never do that because they don't get along and they fight and argue and the kids drive them crazy and all that. But this is why it's so important to understand how to heal your own energy, right? What we do in all of the courses inside of Hot Moms.